Coming at your mouth with your blah, blah, blah. Zip your lip like a padlock.
Good morning, and thank you for joining. Many of you in this room are my friends. Many of you in this room know me. Many of you cheer for me, have worked with me, and have supported me. Not every one of you has a good reason to be critical of me. I want to say to each of you simply and directly, I'm deeply sorry for irresponsible, selfish behavior I engaged in. I know people want to find out how I could be selfish and so foolish. People want to know I could have done these things with my wife and lean into my children. I've always tried to be a private person, but there's some things I want to say. Lean into the person that doesn't damage my behavior, and Lee pointed out to my real apology will come through in the form of words that will come in behavior over time. We lots to discuss, however, and we have each will remain between the two of us. I'm also aware of my pain, but being this point to those in the room. I have let you down. I have told you, my fans, for those of you, especially my friends, my behavior has been personal disappointment. For those of you who work for me, I have let you down personally, professionally. My behavior has caused considerable worry to my business partner. To everyone involved in my foundation, including my staff, my board of members, sponsors, most importantly, the young students who reach out and work for more than ever. 13 years ago, my dad and I envisioned helping young people achieve their dreams through education. The work we made unchangeable continued to grow. From the learning centers in Southern Chicago to Earlwood Scholars in Washington City, millions of kids have changed their lives, and I am dedicated to making sure that it continues. But still, I know I have bitterly disappointed you, and I've made you the question of who I am now, and I could have done better, but things I am embarrassed have put you in this mission. For all that I have done, I say I'm sorry. I have a lot to atone for, but there is one issue I really want to discuss. Some people expect that Alina somehow have hurt or attacked me Thanksgiving night, and it angers me that people would fabricate this kind of story. Alina never hit me in that night or any other night. It's been an episode of domestic violence in a marriage. Alina showed enormous grace and points throughout our ordeal. Alina deserves praise up. The issue involved me with my repeated irresponsible behavior. I'm saying I had affairs. I cheated. What I not accept the only person to blame. I supposed to live by the core values I should have been loved. I knew my actions were wrong, but I convinced myself that the normal rules didn't apply. I never thought about it. I was hurting. Instead, I thought of only about myself. I write through the boundaries that a married couple should live by. I thought I could get away with it. Whatever I wanted to do, I felt that I worked hard my entire life and deserved to enjoy all the temptations around me. I felt they entitled thanks to the money and fame. I didn't have to go that far. I was wrong. I was foolish. I didn't get paid by different rules. The same boundaries that applied to everyone that applied to me. I brought the shame on myself and I hurt my wife, my kids, my mother, my family, my friends, my foundation, and kids all around the world who admire me. I had lots of time to think about what I've done. My failures made me look at myself and I never wanted to before. Now make amends and start to never repeating mistakes I made and up to living the tragedy. I have a long way to go. I want truth and believe it's true. It's not what you achieve in your life that matters. Is what you have become. Achievements in the golf course, only part of the steady example. Characters in DC and what really counts. Parents used to point to me a role model for the kids that live in the family. Apology, I want to say that they am truly sorry. It's torture that I need, but I do for 45 days. And the end of September, in the early February, I was in inpatient therapy receiving guidance for the issues I'm facing. I have a long way to go, but I'm taking the first steps in my right to section. As I proceed, I understand people have questions. They enter the press wants me for details and time. I was unfaithful. I understand people want to know whether Alina and we remain together. People know that as far as I'm concerned, every one of these questions and answers matter between Alina and me. The issues are not a husband and wife. Some people admit of things that never happened. They said I performed enhancing drugs. This is completely utterly false. They've written things about my family despite the damage I've done. I still believe it's right to shield my family from the public spotlight. You do not do these things. I did. I've always maintained this private space for my wife until they've been kept separate from my sponsors, my commercial adults, and my children were born. We released only photographs of the paparazzi and us to chase them. However, my behavior does not make it right for media to follow me 2.5-year-old daughter to school and report the school's location, the stake that my wife and pursued my mom. Whatever my wrong things to stake my family, please leave my wife and kids alone. I recognize I've worked this all myself and I know all about the one who needs to change, and I owe it to my family to become a better person and to those who are close to me become a better man. That's where focus will be. I've done a lot of work and intend to dedicate myself to doing it. Part of following me is the Buddhism, which my mother taught me at a young age. People probably don't realize it, but I've betrayed the Buddhism. I actually practiced the faith for a child and I drifted away for many recent years. Buddhism teaches that a craving for things outside of itself causes unhappy and pointless search for security. Teaches me to stop following every impulse and to learn restraint. Obviously, I lost track of what I was taught. As I move forward, I continue to receive help because I learned how people really do. Starting tomorrow, I will leave for more treatment and more therapy. I would like to thank my friends and the Accenture and the plays and the field working for understanding why I'm making these remarks today. In therapy, I've learned the importance of looking at my spiritual side, keeping in balance in my professional life. I need to regain my balance and be centered so I can think the things that are most important to me in my marriage and my children. That also means relying on others to help. I learned to seek support from my peers and therapy. I hope to someday return that support to others who are seeking help. And I do plan to return to God one day. I just don't know what day that will be. I don't rule out that that will be this year. When I do return, I need to make my behavior more respectful to the game. In recent weeks, I've had many thousands of emails, letters, phone calls from people expressing good wishes. Good wishes. To everyone who's reached out to me, my family, thank you. Your encouragement means the world to me. And Elaine, I want to thank the PGA Tour, Commissioner Ventrum, and the players for their patience and understanding why I work on my private life. I look forward to seeing my fellow players on the course. Finally, there are many people in this room. There are many people at home. Believe me, today I wish to ask for help. I ask you to find in your heart to one day believe in me again. Thank you.